Good morning, Mr. Basil. How's it going?
Very well. How are you, Alex?
I'm very good, sir. I'm very good. Right, tell us what we have this week then.
Well, we've got Rosa Island, or Rose Island as it is on Netflix. But I think it is Rosa, because that's how the Italian second name would be pronounced. So we'll say Rosa Island, which is kind of a film, a true depiction of a gentleman. Is it Giorgio? He's an engineer by heart, and obviously a misfit and a bit of an odd character, because you get introduced to him and you can see he's not very normal. Like, you know, he's one of these intellectual wizards, but you know, he's not of the normal world. Anyway, so you get introduced to him and he's a bit of a character, and you see him in a pub at first, and he just doesn't fit into this world in 1967, I think it was 67 68 70,
and Italy, so this is all in Italy.
Yeah, and in the first 10 minutes, you see that he used to be with this beautiful woman called Gabriella, and they meet in this bar again, and they're just discussing about why they broke up. And then he offers to take her home in this lovely old car, and essentially gets pulled over.
His own invention, the car?
Yeah. His own invention. He's got, but at the same time, you know, it goes back to that thing. He's got no license. He's got no registration plates. So they get pulled over and he gets arrested. So essentially she says, you just need your own world, mate. And you haven't got your own world. And he has this spontaneity idea of, I'm going to make my own world.
Epiphany.
Yeah, this epiphany. Yeah. Anyway, so it's a great way they show that kind of scene where he gets the idea, because he's just working another job in like just after that scene. But anyway, so and then it comes to this crazy storyline where he's making, off the coast of Italy, a mere 3 miles, four miles off the coast of Italy, his own island, which is just made out of steel beams in the ground,
like
water.
It's like
a platform, like a helicopter platform, but a big one. And then it turned into this kind of like strange story of like man versus state, really, in which even though it's a tiny platform, it gets so popular and world renowned that the Italian government almost feel threatened by this, because it might they're insecure that more and more people might be doing this, and so it's a very interesting story. And also it kind of gets that love story going on again, because his ex-wife is kind of more interested in him again, because he has literally made his own world. So anyway, what did you think of it, Alex?
The things we do to impress the missus, right? Pretty much. But this guy actually,
that was a big point made in the
island.
Film, yeah. Yeah, so it was driven by love.
Exactly. Let's just remember that this is based on a true story. So this actually happened in history in Italy. So it's just such a fun film to watch, man, because this guy has got so much energy to do what he's on to do and go against the system. And he finds this loophole in the law where he says, I can actually build 5 miles off the coast of Italy. I can do whatever
waters.
I want. It's international waters. I can do whatever I want. And he even goes to Strasbourg, to the European Union, to apply for his own laws to become his own state and have international rights just like any other state. And obviously this annoys massively the Italian government, because if one man can do it, who's stopping everybody else to do it? And it gets into this much complicated story, but it's really good, because the way the film looks, it reminded me of a Wes Anderson film, because it's colorful. It's got these really larger than life characters in the ministers, the Italian ministers, and himself, the engineer, and his friends that he needs to rely on to bring people over.
Yeah.
And sometimes
the
visuals are even very colorful and light and lighthearted. And also his own the main character, Giorgio, is really like, in his eyes, the acting, you're seeing his wheels going really quick.
It was a great bunch of people thrown together at the start, isn't there, to like start off the islands, like seven of them, and they're all a little bit odd characters, but they just make a good team, don't they? But as you say, the way it looks, like the opening like 2 or 3 minutes, when you see him going to the European court in Strasbourg. And it's fantastic, those opening scenes, isn't it? You know, because it's all big grand buildings and a really cold environment and lovely old-fashioned cars.
And concrete buildings, scary, to be honest, like an evil genius lair. And he has to go to the politics and the bureaucracy of it. And actually the bureaucracy part in the Italian government later on plays a big part, because, you know, at one point the current president is just about to go out of finish his term. And then the Secretary of Defense comes down and tries to get him to sign off to blow up this island, yes, basically attack it.
Yes.
And he's like, yeah, whatever, it's the end of my term anyway, so I'm just going to sign whatever it is. So it's also all that sort of stuff that is just is so well put together. And also, yeah, digital, I mean, the fact that it's very similar to Wes Anderson's films is what attracted me to it the most. I was laughing pretty much all the way to it. Because, or you remember the film by, was it Kubrick with the bomb? The How I Learned to Love the Bomb.
Oh, yeah.
It reminded me a bit of that too, because these guys in the government, they actually, around the table, they talk about serious, potentially international conflict.
Yeah, I like the humour. I think I know what scene you're talking about. It's like, you can see it's like the governing body of Italy. They're all having that communal meeting, aren't they, at one point? And then they adjourn the meeting, and then is it the Secretary of Defence? He goes, there is one slight problem, and they all want to go for coffee and tea and coffee. And he's like, what are you referring to? And I'm like, well, it's just a group of people on a platform, you know, 5 miles off the coast of, you know, Italy. And they're all like, right, okay, and what? And he's like, yeah, he might have gone to the European Council. And it starts off as just an off comment, and then it literally ends up with them saying, we need to send the Navy to them to destroy it. And it's just like, and this is all true. This is all true. It's just fascinating, man, you know.
Yeah,
I won't spoil anything, but there is a great scene, there's like a great standoff scene, isn't there, towards the end, where there's this naval carrier and our, you know, band of merry freedom fighters, and you'd love to think that actually happened the way it was depicted, because it's literally huge naval vessel, guns pointed at the island.
Pretty much as big as the island, if not bigger than that.
Exactly,
island,
if not bigger, yeah. And you really hope that isn't, you know, made for a movie scene, and that actually happened, don't you?
Yes, yeah. Well, apparently it did, because at the end, after the credits, they show you photos of the actual island, how it looked like, and the Navy ship, how it looked like. So it was really good. But you get all this sort of humor all the time. And it's all plays on the fact that this actually happened, which is just mental.
Amazing.
So,
it's amazing. Yeah, and yeah. I don't think the Italian government, how they responded, would get away with what they did if they did it today, because
no
it's just completely
chance.
Authoritarian and just stamping out of anyone who tries to, you know, it's insane, wasn't it? It's insane.
Absolutely, yeah. So it's called Rosa Island, and it's on Netflix.
Rose Island.
It's actually fairly new. It's not an old film. It's from last year, I believe. So yeah, good.
Yeah.
Cool. All right. Talk to you later, sir.
All right. Take care, Alex.
Bye bye.